बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक फॉर डिस्कशन इज टैक्सोनॉमिक करेक्टर्स। हियर वी डिस्कस टैक्सोनॉमिक करेक्टर। व्हाट इज टैक्सोनॉमिक करेक्टर? ए टैक्सोनॉमिक करेक्टर इज एनी एट्रीब्यूट ऑफ ए मेंबर ऑफ ए टैक्सोन बाय विच इट डिफर और मे डिफर फ्रॉम ए मेंबर of a different taxon, a characteristic by which member of two taxa agree but differ from member of a third taxon is a taxonomic character. So not all the taxonomic character are equally useful. Some are powerful indicator of relationship and other are not. The usefulness of a character depends on its information content. Functions of taxonomic character. They have diagnostic aspects as indicator of difference. They function as indicator of relationship. Also act as key characters, easily produced variability representing materials which help in classification of organisms. Taxonomic characters reveals that not all taxonomic characters are equally useful. Some are powerful indicator of relationship and other are not. The usefulness of character depends on its information contents. There are different types of taxonomic characters. Number one is morphological characters. Number two is physiological characters. Number third, behavioral characters. Number four, ecological characters. Number five, geographic characters. Number six, molecular characters. Now we discuss these characters one by one. Number one is morphological characters. Morphological character having attribute of organism, of shapes and outward appearance of a particular taxon, is the usual feature for recognizing particular taxa, and it is easily observable. Many morphological characters are considered relative to each other. They describe variation in size, shape and counts of homologous structures. This helps to unreveal three basic problem of character analysis, which are character state definition, delimitation and ordering. So we now discuss these as follows. General external morphology. Superficial features easy to diagnose, for example feathers on birds, scales on reptiles and arthropods, external skeleton, plumage of bird which is actually layer of feather that cover a bird, and the pattern, color and arrangement of those feathers. Pelage of mammals. The coat of mammals consisting of fur, hair and wool, scale count of fishes and reptiles. So we can distinguish different animals like fishes by counting scales. Another is special structures. For example, genitalia. Different genital structure of each species help in reproductive isolation. Difference in Genitalic structure has been used to delimit species. It is very effective in insects where lock and key relationship exists between male and female copulatory organs. Color pattern and other aspect of coloration are among the most easily recognized and thus the most convenient character in certain groups of animals, for example, birds. Then is the internal morphology. Both the soft as well as hard parts of practically all groups of higher animals have been used as taxonomic character. For example, skull structure of higher animals. Then is the larval stages and embryology. Various immature or larval stages, the embryology and sometimes even the eggs may provide taxonomic information. For example, the various sibling species of Anopheles maculipinus complex were discovered owing to differences in egg structure. The classification of white flies is based primarily on pupae. Comparative studies of embryological character like cleavage pattern, blastulation, gastrulation are also useful in certain phyla. Now you already know about cleavage pattern, whether holoblastic, meroblastic and other as well. At the end, karyology. Karyology is the description of chromosome structure, size, shape and number. Chromosomes are particularly useful in two different levels. On the one hand, they aid in comparison of closely related species, including sibling species. These are often far more different chromosomally than in their external morphology. Dear student, you know about what is sibling species. Sibling species is that one species which is reproductively isolated but morphologically identical. On the other hand, chromosomal patterns are of extreme importance in establishing phyletic lines. Here are some pictures representation of morphological characters. Superficial feature easy to diagnose, feathers on birds and scales on reptiles. Then are the special structure, genitalia. Different genital structure of each species help in reproductive isolations. Then is the internal morphology or anatomy. In higher animals, usually anatomically showing homology. For example, skull structure of higher animals. Then is the embryology, in which cleavage pattern, for example, holoblastic or meroblastic, then blastulation, gastrulation, these are the developmental stages of animals. Here is the embryonic development in different species of vertebrates. Among these are shark, lizard, chicken, pig and humans, which also having distinguished characteristics of different animal taxon. Here is the karyology. Chromosome number in a species help in finding phylogenetic relationship. For example, mammals. Here are groups of different mammals showing number of chromosomes which vary differently. Number two is physiological characters. Physiological characters are certain functions of living organism, like the ability to tolerate temperature and salinity, or the characteristic feature of particular groups of animals. These characters can be observed in living organism only and help to differentiate dissimilar groups of animals. This group of character is hard to define. All structure are the products of physiological processes and thus physiological characters. By physiological characters, only one generally means growth constant, temperature tolerance, and the various processes studied by comparative physiologists. These characters cannot be studied in preserved material. Here is the picture representation of physiological factors. Number one is metabolic factor. Metabolic activities help in finding closely related species. For example, gram positive and gram negative bacteria. Here is the body secretion, form, consistent pattern, find morphology, number, size, and structure of secretory gland. For example, waxy secretion of scales, insects, and mealybugs. For example, scale insects covered with wax is showing in picture.
Thank you, students, for your concentration. We will meet in our next lecture. Till that, Allah Hafiz.